It's one of the most colorful cities in America, as full of flavor as it is people, with homes stacked on top of one another like building blocks. San Francisco, California, has always been a place where the hills are steep, and so too are the issues. This time around, the battle is over circumcisions, to be or not to be.
Forced circumcision is fundamentally a human rights violation. I feel that all children, whether boy or girl, have a fundamental right to all the body parts that they were born with.
Jonathan Conti is part of a group that collected more than 7,000 signatures in favor of banning what they call male genital mutilation within the city limits, enough to put the issue on the November ballot. If passed, the circumcision of anyone under 18 would be a crime, resulting in jail time and a $1,000 fine. This outraged religious groups, who see it as a direct attack on their religious rights. Jews, like Abby Porth, have joined forces with Muslims to defend age-old traditions.
This is a hate-fueled campaign to curtail civil liberties in San Francisco.
She and many argue it's a parent's choice. The majority of American men are circumcised, and according to the World Health Organization, circumcised men have a lower risk of penile cancer, sexually transmitted diseases, and a 60% less chance of contracting HIV. But at the center of this debate, religion.
People want to have their kids circumcised, they should. I mean, major religions believe in it for over 2,000 or 3,000 years. So I think it's a little bit of a slap at Jews and Muslims too, to say circumcision is now illegal.
Your freedom to practice religion ends at someone else's body. Religion is not a blank check to inflict harm upon your children. The vast majority of the world, Central America, South America, New Zealand, Australia, most of Europe, the practice is virtually unheard of.
Some have taken it a step further. Matthew Hess, the author of the bill, is also the creator of the comic Foreskin Man, a superhero that saves babies from the evil doctors and parents trying to circumcise them.
This comic book has some of the most disgusting, vile, anti-Semitic images that appear to be lifted out of Nazi-era propaganda. The idea that, you know, Foreskin Man is an Aryan-looking superhero who's going to come and save babies from the evil Jewish, you know, bloodthirsty rabbi is disgusting.
The debate over circumcision has polarized this city, with people taking sides on both religious and personal grounds. Well, it will all come to a head here at San Francisco Civil Court, where a judge will decide whether or not the issue will be left up to voters, some of whom say they'll vote to leave things as they are.
If you make a law about it, that's going to, like, offend a lot of people. Like, there's a lot of history there.
Let them make their own decisions, and let them, I trust them to make the right decision for their children, too.
And others who say they may be children at the time of the procedure, but it's a decision they have to live with when they grow up.
This is a baby life, you know, actually, you know, man life, you know, and it's not baby decision.
Vote or no vote, the battle lines over circumcision have now expanded far beyond the borders of San Francisco, becoming a national debate, bringing what was once a purely private issue into the public domain. Reporting in San Francisco, Christine Frizzell, RT.